Time TV. I'm Alicia Fanan. In today's episode of Gems of Goa COVID Hero Series, we have with us once again Dr. Uday Kakodkar. Now he is the administrator at the ESI COVID Hospital. Hello, Doctor. Welcome to Prime TV.
Yeah, thank you for having me,
Doctor.
On the show.
Once again, almost a year after.
Yeah, I think it's time for us to rise up to the occasion and address to the public at large. We as medical fraternity. Would like to take this opportunity and thank Prime TV for having me on board so that I can address the people of Goa on this burning issue. Rather, I would say we are at war and each of and every one of us have to join hands to defeat this menace of COVID-19.
Definitely, Doctor. Doctor, to begin with, the second wave, now we can say it is already peaking up in the state of Goa. What is the current situation? You have always been brutal honest to us whenever we asked you any question regarding, be it COVID, be it about anything, misconceptions related to it, or for that matter, anything. At the moment, what is the situation like? Please tell us.
Yeah, see, I will just give you exact figures. Like when it was on 4th of February, it is almost coming to 2 months, you can say now, that the number of cases in Goa.
Correct.
Were 400 and odd, they were less than 500. And if you read yesterday evening's figures that have been put up by the Director of Health Services, they are 15,600 and odd. So you can imagine the number of cases that are there. Secondly, the deaths were barely about 700 and odd. They have gone to 1,086. So almost 300 deaths have occurred within less than 2 months. And the other thing is that, we are, as doctors and all the healthcare workers have been in this COVID for last 1 year. So we are all human. It is but natural that we are all exhausted. And the only way to control this menace or to help the doctors in controlling this problem is that, like, we, each and every person, each and every citizen of Goa has to rise up to the occasion and see to it that how one can contribute not to increase the number of cases. So this can be done by observing social distancing. Second, use of mask. And whenever we say use of mask, you know, that mask should not be on the neck. Mask should not be only on the nose, only on the mouth. It has to be covering the your nose as well as the mouth, because we do breathe through our nose. So living
definitely,
the mouth,
doctor.
Inhaling the virus. You are inhaling the virus and bring it home, and then you give it to your own elderly people, to all the others in the family.
Yes, definitely, doctor. As we have seen last wave, like the first wave, what we saw in Goa, and now when we see. The difference is that the cases are rapidly increasing. So what could be the main reason for this right now?
The reason could be that one thing is that, what happens, a virus does keep on changing its shape. It's like changing clothes, so because now the scientists, the doctors have devised ways to kill a virus. So virus also tries to change its structure so that it makes itself not amenable to the treatment that is being given by the doctor. So this is called mutation. Mutation is basically just change in the structure. It's like virus putting on one new set of clothes, which make them immune to all the medicines and all the other things that we give to them. So because of that, we find that the virus has become more virulent. By that, I mean the virus is more aggressive now. Virus is affecting people at a faster rate. It is affecting the newer sections of the society. For example, younger people are getting affected. The children are getting affected, which were there in the last wave. So naturally, the burden is increasing because children are affected, younger population is affected. And we know that younger population do not like to stay home. And that is... we are finding more number of cases, and not just the more number of cases, the more number occurring in a shorter time. So,
Doctor, exactly, which brings me to my next question right now. As you have been mentioning that this second wave is more deadly for the younger generation. So in specific, if you have a closer look at this entire scenario, what is the way in which one, it is always said that early detection is the key to getting at least being able to handle the virus. So yeah. What is the early stages, or what exactly can we say, when can we say that it is early detection and one needs to go for a test?
Yeah, see, first of all, now we know that there is a community spread. So any person who is having fever, now that there is a community spread, we have got plenty of cases. Like I told you, like 15,000 cases every day, 2,500, 3,000 cases are occurring, coming up and adding to the already existing pool of the number of patients that are there. So within 2 months from 400, we have come to 15,000 odd cases. So any person who is having fever, even a 1 day duration, come on, get yourself tested. Second, if there's a body ache, if there is cough of any severity, don't just neglect any cough. They should immediately get tested. Second thing is that, if you have any person who is in your house already tested, see to it that try to isolate him. Whenever you deal with such a person, if you do not have facilities for keeping him in a separate room, at least make sure that everybody in the house wear a mask. Everybody in the house.
In the house, doctor?
Inside the house, because one of the person is detected positive, no. So for
waiting for the results, you're saying. Till the time the person doesn't get their own results, each one needs to wear a mask in the house.
Till the time the other person doesn't get his result, make sure that you wear a mask in the house also, because that is the only way that you can protect. Secondly, social distancing. Do not venture out unless and until it is absolutely necessary. Just don't go out to meet somebody. Just don't go out to party or to have food outside. See, there is still time. All these things can be done provided one is alive to enjoy this in future. So make sure this is just going to take another 1 or 1.5 months. Hold on. Just hold on. Postpone all your engagements, whatever your appointments are there, for at least for about 1.5 months. Which are avoidable, which you can postpone, and do not just go out of the house whenever not required. Do not party. Do not be a part of any social gathering unnecessarily, and abide by all the rules and regulations and the SOPs which have been put up by the government. See, ultimately, we all have to join hands. It's like, do not wear a helmet to avoid a challenge from police. Wear a helmet to avoid an accident and shave your face, shave your head. So that is what I mean to say. So do not wait for the government to make any rules. Make rules for your own self so that you are safe and you also keep your family, you keep your state and your country safe. So this is the responsibility of each and every citizen of this country to see to it that we now contribute to controlling the menace of COVID.
I think very rightly said, doctor. Well, on that note, we'll take a short break. On the other side of the break, we still have doctors, so stay tuned. We'll be right back.
This is Infomedia Prime Slot Network. And you're watching Prime. Your voice, your channel.
Welcome back. We are in conversation with Dr. Uday Kakodkar. Doctor, now when we discuss about the next phase, this phase of second wave is very dangerous and people need to take precautions. That's the only way in which they can at least identify when they have tested positive for it. So now, what, as you already told us about the various ways, like suppose if you get cold, do not take it lightly. If you get fever or somebody in your area gets that, do not take lightly. The first step is to isolate, because we need to break the chain at the earliest. So in such a scenario, very recently, the government came up with the home isolation list, the guidelines for home isolation. So yes. In such a scenario, what is your opinion, doctor? When is it that, one needs to move from home isolation to the hospital?
Yeah. So whom do we home isolate, first of all? We home isolate people who are mild disease. Now, what do we call a mild disease? A person who is having mild symptoms, means he has got a fever of 100 or less than that. If a person who has got mild cough, a cough is gets occasionally or sometimes, that cough that is not really distressing, the cough that is not continuous, the cough that is, doesn't bring about like any blackouts and all to him. Now, such a fever, and patient is very comfortable. He does not have any breathing difficulty. And many of people now, almost I think most of the people have got that pulse oximeter at home. So if you go by the pulse oximeter criteria, if any person can maintain his oxygen saturation of 94 and above on room air, means like he just breathing the air that we all have to breathe. If such a person with a pulse oximeter has a saturation of 94 and above, he is called as a mild disease. Such a person should not unnecessarily put pressure on the government to admit him, because he is preventing a bed for a more serious patient. We are short of beds now. Now, let me be very honest and frank and tell the truth to the people of Goa, because they should realize the seriousness of this problem. Today, government cannot provide a bed to each and every person. There is shortage of oxygen. Let us accept this fact. Why there is shortage? Because the number of patients that are coming are far, far more than what we ever imagined. And you cannot give oxygen bed to each and every person. So try to limit the spread. So mild disease person is the one who has to be isolated at home. Please do not demand for beds or hospitalization for a mild disease. Stay at home. There is a home isolation kit in which each and every medicine that is required for the person is given to it. Now, while you are at home, you have to see only two things. Whether your saturation oxygen level is dropping below 93 is one. Second, whether your fever is continuing despite taking medication. If the fever continues for more than 5 days, then that is a time to worry. If your saturation is dropping below 93, it's a time to worry. If you are feeling out of breath, you are getting difficulty in breathing, that is a time to worry. Then there's one small test that a person can do at home, which is called a 6-minute walk test. You walk briskly for 6 minutes and note your oxygen saturation level. If that drops by 6%, means suppose like if the saturation on 98, it comes to, let's say, 92. That means there is a drop of 6%. Such a person is a warning sign. Any person who is becoming breathless is a warning sign. Any person who is getting very high grade fever is a warning sign. Then, who are the people who need to worry? People who are above 60 years of age. People having those comorbidities. What do you mean by comorbidities? People having diabetes, people having hypertension, people who are on long term steroid doses. People who are having cancer, people who are very obese people. So such people are the people who are a high risk group, who also have to take things seriously. They should also make sure that these people, if their problem is not under control, make sure that you tell your doctor who is monitoring you that be very honest. Don't try to avoid hospitalization. Be very honest. Tell him frankly. What is your monitoring progress? And doctor tells you that you need to move to a hospital. Do not hesitate. Do not waste time. Do not try to call up many more people to take opinions after opinion. Come on, get back to hospital.
Exactly, doctor. That is one of the major problems which people face, that they like to take, they delay the entire process in the long run. Correct. Considering this.
Yeah, the delay is occurring from the patient level at various levels. First of all, they ignore the symptoms and they don't go for testing. They keep on taking crozin on their own and wait for like somebody to tell them now you have to go. So they observe at home for 6 days, 7 days, 8 days. Such a thing should not be done. Immediately on getting any symptom, come on, get yourself tested. Because once you test, you quarantine till your test result comes. Now, compared to the last year, now the results are coming late after some few days, because the sheer number of samples that we are handling has far exceeded
too much
our capacity to test is. So after you test, please do not move out, because now you are a suspect. You can give a disease to others. So try to quarantine, be in the house, don't move out, wear a mask till your result comes. If your result comes, immediately you will be started on treatment and observe all the instructions that are given in that home isolation kit. Follow the doctor's advice, make yourself all right, and make sure that you don't give the disease to others.
Definitely, doctor. Also, if you have a closer look, as you already mentioned, that there's a lot of pressure that has come in to the health workers in such a scenario. We have seen videos where doctors themselves are pushing trolleys, and the pressure has come directly onto the healthcare or the frontline warriors, to be specific. In such a scenario, like you mentioned, the home isolation is one thing. But now, in case somebody has to be admitted, what are the ways and what are the things that one needs to keep in mind once the person is admitted in the hospital?
Yeah. See, first of all, to get to a hospital, we have got an excellent 108 facility available. If you are not getting 108, because they are also in a limited number and the number of patients are more. So get in your own car, because, you know, it's not that. See, there's so much of community spread is there that you need not worry. Now, come on, get in your own car and come to the nearest primary health center and meet the doctor over there. The doctor will take decision. Once you are with the doctor, now the onus lies with the doctor to decide where to send you, where to admit you. He has got resources to find out where the bed is available, which patient has to go to which hospital. All that will be decided by the doctor. So you are detected positive, please do not panic. First of all, most importantly, do not panic. Stay calm and cool and follow the doctor's advice. And now there is one more way of improving your oxygen system, which we call as proning, means lying on your tummy. So for that also, like, you should not press your chest and all. You have to have enough of pillows under your thigh area and pillow under the shin and now pillow under the neck and lie prone to improve saturation levels and all. This he has to do at least every 2 hourly. He can change position. He can lie on either side and on the tummy. And only one precaution taken: should not lie on your tummy at least for 1 hour after having food. So if you want to do that, should be done on full stomach immediately after having food. One should not lie on the tummy, but it should be delayed by 1 hour after having food.
Yes, doctor. So there are a lot of questions which have come in already from the people regarding COVID and what are the misconceptions about the second wave and everything of that sort. That we will do on the other side of the break. So stay tuned. We'll be right back on the other side of the break.
This is InfoMedia Prime Slot Network, and you're watching Prime. Your voice, your channel.
Welcome back. We are in conversation with Dr. Uday Kakodkar, who is the administrator at the ESI COVID Hospital, Margao. Doctor, now we have certain questions. As I mentioned before we go on to this break, that there are certain questions which have come in from people asking about the various things that they feel and various questions that they have with the second wave. So very quickly, I'll get started. As usual, I'll not be naming the person who has sent us the question, but I will definitely ask you the question directly. Okay, so to begin with, the first question is, can CT scan detect the virus or at least the damage done in the lungs?
Let me tell you, first of all, no, like, there is a wrong concept in the people's mind that CT scan is the answer for everything. See, the only test that detects the virus is a swab test. Now what has happened compared to the last year, we are finding at least about 30% of the people, means one in three, 30% of the people may come RT-PCR negative. But if a RT-PCR negative does not mean that a patient does not have COVID. In such a patient, if there are symptoms, if he is breathless, CT scan would help you. But before that, an X-ray chest can be done. If X-ray shows that pneumonia, you require CT scan only to find out whether it is a mild, moderate or severe pneumonia. But CT scan is not a must in each and every case. You can do the same thing by the X-ray chest. If X-ray shows any doubt, the doctor will advise for a CT scan. But whoever can afford, I would say, like, would not want to waste the time. If they want to go for CT scan, they are free to do it. But CT scan does not detect a virus. It is a swab test that detects virus. But CT scan can give you an idea whether it is a COVID pneumonia or not.
And also with regard to early detection, there are a lot of questions which have also come in with regard to, for the early detection, CT scan comes in handy?
Yes, definitely it comes handy, especially in patients whose RT-PCR test is going to take 4 or 5 days. The CT scan report you take in 1 hour. So that way, by not wasting so many days, CT scan would be definitely handy. Because if the CT scan shows picture suggestive of COVID, you need not wait for the swab test report to come. Immediately, such a patient can very well be started on treatment.
Oh, okay. The next question is with regard to vaccination. Is vaccination safe? Still doubts are there in people's minds.
Absolutely. Absolutely. I would like to repeat again the word absolutely. Please be rest assured that we in India have given 14 crore vaccinations, and we have definitely seen that people who have got vaccinated get milder disease, do not require hospitalization, do not require oxygen, do not require ventilator, obviously, and the people dying due to COVID can definitely be prevented by vaccination. It's one of the best tools that we have in our hand. So I would appeal to people who have not vaccinated, please get yourself vaccinated, because the number of beds are less, the oxygen beds are less, number of oxygen cylinders are less, drugs are going in short supply. Keeping in that in mind, make sure that get yourself vaccinated so that you don't end up in a hospital and on a ventilator.
Definitely. Also, with regard to this, another question related to vaccination is in terms of a person having comorbidity, can that person too get vaccinated?
All the more. Rather, I would say any person who is having comorbidities should rather on priority. So, he is the person who should rather go on priority and get himself vaccinated.
What are the measures? Another question which has come in is in terms of what are the measures for children which one needs to keep in mind? We the other day we had a press conference with Dr. Bandekar at in Panjim, where he stated clearly that till now, in touch wood, till now there's nothing in terms of for children specifically in Goa for COVID. So what are the things that one needs to keep in mind for children specifically?
See, whatever applies to adults, like grown-up people, also applies to children. Now, the problem with children is that if they are very too small, children will not be able to complain. So you have to, the parents or the other members in the family have to look for them. Like have to see that if the child is not looking very normal, child is looking very tired, and child having fever and does not look his normal self. Do not wait for the child to complain, because some children are too small to complain. So the onus lies on the parents, onus lies on other members of the family to look for symptoms in the children. And again, the symptoms are one and the same. Whatever symptoms occur in the grown-up, the same thing occur in the children also. So any such child should be immediately be taken to a doctor, get checked. And most of the children, there is no specific treatment for any viral illness. But children having a moderate or severe disease would also require the same treatment that a adult would require, and that would be taken care of by the doctor. So we as citizens, okay, our duty is that look for symptoms, don't waste time, rush to the doctor and follow the doctor's advice. And three things, and impressing three things: social distancing, wearing a mask, and hand sanitization is of prime importance to be followed by each and every citizen. Cooperate with the law enforcing agencies, cooperate with the government, because ultimately it is to save your own life. Do not flout any rules. Just hold on to yourself. This is going to take just another 1.5 months or so. We will all come out of it, provided we will all hold on to our own self and make a self-discipline. Do not wait for government to make the rules. Self-discipline yourself.
Very rightly said, doctor. Another question what we have got in terms of a person who has done the eye operation. Taking steam is okay with that particular person?
I didn't get your question. Eye operation meaning?
Like in terms of cataract. Yeah, and undergone an eye operation, like a cataract or a glaucoma kind of.
Okay, yeah. Then
we can't think that way right now. So can that person take steam?
Eye operation could be that. Because that will damage the eyes.
Should not.
The steam inhalation is not of absolute importance in a patient who has undergone an eye operation. See, his eye operation, okay. Eye operation can become a failure. Tomorrow he will become okay from COVID, but he will lose his sight. He will lose his vision. So which is of prime importance. So a person who has undergone an eye operation should not take steam inhalation.
Okay. So that is one thing which that person needs to keep in mind. Additionally, as you already mentioned about proning was one topic which was there, like how long should I do proning? Which, if doctor, very briefly, you can just repeat about it.
Yeah, first of all, proning is what, you know, lying on your tummy. And this has been found to improve your oxygen levels. So you, mm-hmm. you yourself can test it. I would like to tell the patients or the people, like those people who are having lesser saturation, if they lie on their tummy, then this positioning has to be taken for 2 hours, or if they can do it for more than 2 hours, like say 3 hours at a stretch, they can very well go for it. And it mm-hmm. has to be, only thing, precaution is that it should not be pressing your tummy. You require some 3 or 4 pillows under the thighs, one pillow under the lower on the shin, and one pillow over the head portion. And lie on your tummy so that you don't press your actual tummy. Tummy should be free to breathe. The chest also should be mm-hmm. free to breathe. And it should be done 1 hour after having food. So immediately after food, one should not lie on the tummy. And this positioning can be done every 2 hourly. You can lie on the right side, you can lie on the left side, and also lie on your tummy. So lying on the tummy does improve oxygenation level. This is called proning that we see, and it does help.
Okay. Doctor, another very quickly, one more question which we can take right now is about double mask. Will double mask help me with regard to saving myself from COVID?
No, I don't think so. See, first of all, you wear one mask, but wear it properly. That is, and it should be a tightly and properly fitting mask. Make sure that your nose as well as the mouth is covered, and it is a properly fitting mask. Make sure that you don't fiddle with your mask every now and then, because that way you are compromising with your safety. So wearing a double mask doesn't mean that you get extra protection. Wear one mask, but wear it properly. Wear it the way the way it should be worn. It should be tight mask. Do not remove it every now and then. Do not remove when you are talking to somebody. That's a common habit we have seen with people. They will wear a mask the moment they meet somebody. They will take the mask down and then start talking to him. This is very, very dangerous. Please do not remove your mask at any point of time when you are with other person. Talk to him by maintaining a distance of 1 meter. Wash your hands repeatedly, and social distancing and wearing a mask. These 3 things, again and again, I would like to impress upon people. Please follow these 3 things to help us to control COVID and help to save lives.
Doctor, I think you all are doing some amazing job, and Prime TV salutes all the COVID warriors, especially to you as well, as you're working continuously. Before you leave, any particular message that you would like to give to our viewers, if you can just say a few words on that.
The only message that I have to the people at large is that please help us to save your lives. And this you can do by observing the COVID appropriate behavior. Secondly, if you overburden a hospital by increasing the number of cases, you will ultimately find that you will not have any beds for patients to treat, which is already occurring in Goa now. Secondly, the more the number of patients, the longer I work, I'm more likely to get infected myself. So I will end up as a patient. You will find doctors filled up, hospitals filled up with doctors, and you will not have any doctors to treat you. So take care of yourself. COVID appropriate behavior is all that I expect you as a doctor from you. So we as Goans, we as Indian citizens have a lot at stake to make sure that we control this second wave, because this second wave is very, very dangerous. Very, very, I would not call it a wave. It's already become a tsunami. So the only way to survive is to try to cut and break the chain of spread. And this can be only done by if we all follow the rules that we all know and make rules for your own self. Don't wait for the government to tell you. Stay home, stay safe is what I would like to tell you. And once again, I would like to thank Prime TV for giving me the opportunity to interact with the people of Goa. Thank you, Alisha, in particular. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Doctor. Once again, we would like to salute you for the hard work that you all have been doing ever since last year. It is commendable. And you You are truly these gems of Goa. COVID healed. Lot once again, Doctor, you have always answered our questions and always been so brutal with regard to the truth and making sure that we get to know what is the current situation in specific. Thank you so much. And I think in future too, we should have such sessions because thank you so much once again for talking to us.
Thank you very much.
Well, on that note, we come to an end of this episode. Thank you so much for watching Prime TV. Keep watching your favorite show, Gems of Goa, the COVID Heat. We'll bring to you another COVID Heat. So stay tuned. We'll be right back.